everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Cundy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. Welcome to Tattletales. It is nice to have you at home with us. I hope you're having a nice summer. We're having a lovely summer out here in California, I can tell you that. And today, we're going to have a wonderful day, and it's insured by the three super couples we have. Here they are, winning money today for the blue section. Number one, ladies and gentlemen, world champions of the NBA, the National Basketball Association, the Golden State Warriors star, Mr. Rick Barry and his wife, Pam. Welcome to you both. You must forgive me for going on and on. It's so much fun to rattle off those words. Those are such wonderful words. I love saying.
I love hearing them. You can keep saying them all day if you like.
Yeah, you can keep enjoying it until the time to start again, and then they come at you again, right?
For sure.
Pam, how does it feel to be with Rick at this particular time in his life? It's a great time.
Oh, it's always nice to be with him.
Yes. Well, it's not the most diplomatic thing you ever heard in your life. I hope you keep that up. That's terrific. Winning money today for the banana section, ladies and gentlemen. Dressed appropriately enough, I see Donald. Mr. Donald Ross and his wife, Patty Deutsch. How are you, Patty?
Is this a 2 a.m. feeding?
No. Patty and Donald have a brand new baby, Max, who is absolutely adorable. Donald, how does it feel to be a father?
Well, I'm down to my old weight.
No.
No, it's true. And the doctor said I can go swimming now.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. I think.
Did you have a little empathizing? Did you get morning sickness and things like that?
I've had morning sickness for 8 years.
Gee, that's a very long digestion period. Yeah. Or not digestion. What
gestation.
Is that word? Gestation, thank you.
Bert.
You ate the baby? No, I'm sorry.
Bert.
What?
That's not nice. The first week, Donald did lose 5 pounds.
The first week?
The first week that after the baby was born.
He lost 5 pounds?
And the baby weighed 5 pounds, 14 ounces, and Donald lost it.
You know, I'm starting to believe what he said.
It's true.
It's true.
It's true.
Is that a fact?
Sure. Yeah. This is a man that would do anything for me.
That's right. Moving right along, ladies and gentlemen, winning money today for the red section, Mr. Rick Manzie and his wife, Barbara McNair. How are you, Barbara?
Oh, I hope we're better today.
You're going to be terrific.
You know, I don't know how we've been married this long and don't know anything about each other.
Oh, really?
It's very surprising.
You obviously didn't see me and my wife on the show then.
Oh, no, I didn't.
Oh, what a strikeout we were. Rick, are you all set to go?
All set.
Love your outfit. Man, that's super looking. Here we go, gang. If you're ready, this question worth $150 is for you, ladies. Ladies, what's the first clue that your husband is feeling romantic? His words or his actions? Don't laugh now. No laughing, ladies. I don't understand that. Patty is hysterical. Now, you're not supposed to look. What's the first clue that your husband is feeling romantic? His words or his actions? Think it over, ladies, and control yourself, Patty. Goodbye, girls. There they go. Rick, we'll start with Pam.
I have to be first, right?
Yes, you are first today.
Well, Pam's always telling me that I don't speak romantically enough, I guess. So I'm sure that it's my actions. I kind of attack her, you know.
Yeah.
Now, when you got the urge, you got the urge.
Yeah.
I mean, why waste time with small talk, you know?
I agree. Yeah.
I don't think it's safe to sit next to him.
No, it's all right. I believe in your trade it's called a fast break, isn't it?
That's right.
You will say that it's actions, right?
Right, we play a running game in our house.
You grab and she runs. Okay, let's bring her on. Pam.
What took so long?
Well, we're having a good time out here. What's the first clue that your husband is feeling romantic, by his words or his actions?
Since he moves very fast, I will say he doesn't waste time with words and his actions.
Yes, that's it. Almost word for word. Absolutely right. You have a share of the pot. Thank you, Pam. Fast Donald, how about Patty? What's she going to say?
Well, what I usually do is call the hospital and see if there's a room in the maternity ward. You know?
Is that the way?
Yeah.
That's a sure
tip-off. If there's
a
room, then we have a discussion about it.
See.
We have a meeting.
You negotiate.
We negotiate it.
I understand. Right.
So I'm going to say words.
Words?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
What kind of words do you use, Donald? Big words. I mean, you want to give us a catchphrase or two, or would you rather just move right along?
Yeah, there is a catchphrase.
What is the catchphrase?
No, do we have major medical?
Oh, yeah, right. Okay. I hope the answer is always yes. Obviously, it was this time.
We only had it once.
Words it is. Let's bring on Patty. Shh. I'm sorry to hear that. Here she comes now. Here's Patty now.
Hello.
Hey, Patty.
Hey, yeah?
What is the first clue that Fast Donald is feeling romantic? Is it his words or his actions?
He rolls over and takes off his hat.
I believe that's an action. He rolls over and takes off his hat.
She... She swore she never would tell that.
Wait a minute. Now, wait
Donald,
a minute.
Donald, you're supposed to tell the truth.
Are we to believe that Donald wears a hat to bed? Is that what you're saying?
Yes, and it's not for religious purposes.
I mean, I've heard of the old hat trick, but not in bed. It's a very old hat, to say the least.
That is a hockey expression.
Yeah, that's right.
And
it's also a basketball
And I married
expression.
A hockey puck.
Is that your idea of being romantic with words?
And with that, we leave Patty and Donald in the sunset and move right along.
Quickly.
Rick, what is Barbara going to say to this now? Can she tell you romantic? What is the clue? Is it with words or with your actions?
I'd say with words.
With words.
Right.
Okay. What do you mean, aw?
Uh-huh.
You were hoping it was something else? You're going to say words. Let's see what Barbara says. Barbara, what's the first clue that your husband, Rick, is feeling romantic? Is it with his words or his actions?
With his words.
That's what he said. Hey, you're off to a big start today. Rick and Barbara, Pam and Rick, split the pot. We'll be back in a moment with our second question, our second pot. See you in a moment.
It's Buzzer's Pick and Play Summer. Each week, pick your favorites from our weekly matchups.
Ha!
Then watch Fridays to see if your picks make our primetime playlist. Buzzer's Pick and Play Summer, all summer long, continues Friday at 8 on Buzzer.
Thank you. Okay. We're having a little fun here while you were gone. Question number two coming up. Ladies, if you're ready, this is it. It's worth $150 as well. Ladies, let's say you're angry at your husband, but he is unaware of it. So you know that if you bring it up, it'll start an argument. Now, you're dressing to go out and spend a social evening with friends. Will you tell him what's bugging you before you go out, or will you conceal it from him until your social evening is over? Ooh. Let's say you're really angry at your husband, but he is unaware of it. You know that if you bring it up, it's going to start an argument. Now, you're dressing to go out and spend a social evening with friends. Will you tell him what's bugging you before you go out, or will you conceal it from him until your social evening is over? Okay, that's
the... in front of everybody.
Shh, that's the question. Go away and think about it, ladies. We'll be back in a moment. Off they go. Fast, Donald, take your hat off and answer this question, sir. What is she going to do?
No, she
gonna
she would wait until I took my hat off and rolled over.
Yeah,
spring it on that. She would spring it on me at that moment.
Right there, before you go out?
No, no. No, after. She would wait until I paid for the check and everything. She had a hot meal, the whole works.
If she,
I took her out, cabs both ways.
If she's going to wait until after
right.
Fast Donald pays the check, she's going to be there a long time, folks. I mean, you have to understand why we call him Fast Donald. We call him Fast Donald because he's very slow reaching into his breast pocket for the bread. You know what I mean? You don't mind we tell that, Don? That's your nickname, right?
No, not at all.
Not at all. Okay.
No, why don't you get your car out of the lot and run me over at the same time? I don't mind anything. We didn't get the first question right. The host is insulting a guest. I'm having the time of my life here. I love it. And on top of that, the yellow section is mad at me because I wore a red sweater.
No, no. No, they love you. Are you kidding? They love you. They just don't want to be around next time you take your hat off.
Take my hat off.
That's all. Now,
Patty will save it till later.
She's going to wait until, how does it say here? Well, you can see that from him until your social evening is over.
Social evening is over.
Okay, let's bring Patty on. Patty, what are you going to do now? You're going to let him know. You're getting dressed to go out now.
Yeah.
So are you going to tell him what's bugging you before you go out, or are you going to conceal it from him until your social evening is over?
Bert, I would tell him before, during, and after.
However, that's not what the man said.
Wonderful
it's
woman.
It's the seat.
Is it that seat?
It's the seat.
Is that what it is?
The Manzies didn't do well here yesterday either.
Uh-huh. You think that's what it is, huh?
I think so.
I thought it was the light that was attracting them. All right, never mind. That's not what he said. Let's move on down to Rick. What will Barbara say?
Well, she'd tell me before.
She'd tell you right then. She wouldn't waste any time, okay?
Or wait, let me change that.
Okay. Well, think about it a second. Donald, tell a couple of jokes.
You mean mad about going
just,
out? Or?
No, just angry with something about something, and you're not aware of it. She's mad at you. You did something, and you're not even aware what it was. Perhaps you forgot to do something. Whatever it is, not about going out.
Oh, she'd let me know right then.
But you are getting dressed to go out with some friends for the evening.
Well, she'd wait.
But on the other hand, there is still some time before you go out. You think she'd wait till the evening was over?
Right.
That's what you're gonna go with. Okay, right. Let's bring her on. I'll explain it again. Barbara, you're really angry at Rick, but you're getting dressed to go out with some friends for a social evening. Will you tell him what's bugging you before you go out, or will you conceal it from him until the social evening is over?
Oh, I would never start an argument before we go out. I would conceal
it. That's it! All you have to do.
And you have to.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Barbara,
yes.
Maybe Patty's right. It might be the seat. She said it was the seat that back there.
Yeah, but you know what I just found out, Bert?
What is that?
You know, I was saying I don't know how we stayed married this long with all the wrong answers, but the right answer to the first question today is the key.
Is that what it is?
Yes, I found out.
Think
about the first question.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, actions, right? Wasn't that that was the question. Okay, thank you. You have a share of the pot. You're doing beautifully. Rick, what's Pam going to say?
Pam would never start an argument before he went out. She figures I spoil enough evenings on my own, so why should she do it?
Oh, not you. Not you, Rick.
Oh, I've been known to do that occasionally. Sure.
Have you really?
Everybody does it sometime or another.
Yeah, I guess you're right. So you're going to say that she would wait.
Most definitely.
Until the evening is over, let's bring her on and find out. Hello, Pam.
I thought you forgot.
No, no, no. We were just carrying on out here a little bit. Now, you're really mad at Rick. And you don't know what to do. You're getting dressed to go out. What are you going to do? You're going to let him have it before you go out, or are you going to conceal it from him and wait till you come home and then let him have it?
I usually tell him in the car so that he has to take me. But in this instance, I would have to tell him while we're getting dressed.
No, that's not what he said. He said that's the
worst. I don't keep anything inside.
That's the worst.
I don't keep anything inside. You know that.
That's the worst. You're afraid to tell me when you get home.
I'm not afraid of you.
Really?
No.
Well, I am. I can tell you that right now.
No
hey,
chance.
Guess what, gang? Rick and Barbara got the whole thing. It's halftime. We'll change places, fellas. Step to the rear. We'll bring the ladies out front. While we do, we'll break away for a message. We're coming back with a second half. See you in a moment. Change places after halftime. I have the ladies with me, and you got to play catch up to Barbara and Rick, gang. Here we go. This question, fellas, is worth $150. Men, there are many kinds of feminine beauty. There's the classic look, the exotic look, the outdoor scrubbed look. Which of these three would you say best describes your wife? Okay? Here are the choices. There are many kinds of feminine beauty. There's the classic look, the exotic look, the outdoor scrubbed look. Okay, which of these three would you say best describes your wife? I mean, it doesn't have to be on the nose, but close. Okay, you got the choices: the classic look, the exotic look, the outdoor scrubbed look. Think it over, fellas. We'll come back for your answers in a moment. Off they go. Barbara, we'll start with you. What will Rick say to this?
Oh, it's a choice between two. I'm going to take a chance and go with the classic look. How about that, Rick?
Yes, I think so. I would say that, yes. I would go for that in a moment. Let's bring on Rick, see what he says. Rick, your choices are the classic look, the exotic look, or the outdoor scrubbed look. Which look do you think best describes Barbara?
The classic look.
That's it! My goodness.
Good baby.
You got it. Boy, are you hot now. What happened, Rick?
I'm telling
you. You are really cooking. Thank you. Pam, what's Rick going to say?
There's not another category you can throw in.
No, not on my card, is that?
I'll have to go for the outdoor look.
You go for the outdoor look.
Being a former jock myself.
Really? Are you an athlete?
I used to swim.
Oh, really?
So I'll say outdoor.
Okay. Interesting choice of words, what you just said. We could go into that, couldn't we? Like, you'll say the outdoor scrub look. Okay,
yes.
Let's bring him on. Rick, the three choices of feminine beauty that best apply to Pam
we're looking for are the classic look, the exotic look, or the outdoor scrub look. Which would you say is best?
Very difficult, but because Pam likes to do so many outdoor things, and we do a lot, I'd say the outdoor look.
That's it! You're right.
I must point out she could fit every other category.
Now, let's face it, we do. I mean, Barbara is a classic beauty. There's no question about it. And I think that description fits you, too, Pam. We have three beautiful girls on the show today. Patty, why are you making that face?
Huh?
You're adorable. Which feminine beauty is he going to describe you as?
Oh, God help me. I'd only look exotic to a Shriner. I don't think classic enters into it. But I am clean.
Clean beauty is not one on here.
No, you said scrubbed. Outdoor
yes, that's
scrubbed.
Right. That's right, outdoor scrubbed.
I do get out of the house and I am clean.
No, she gets clean outdoors is what she does.
Yeah. I guess that's the closest I've come to.
Okay,
there,
with the
I
outdoor
really
scrub.
Know.
The outdoor scrub look. All right, let's bring him on. Donald. What are the three classifications of your feminine beauty that best describes Patty will be the classic look, the exotic look, or the outdoor scrub look? Which one best describes her, do you think?
I just like the look I get when I take off my hat.
Never mind. Boom. Boom.
Boy, tough question. Classic, exotic, or scrubbed?
Yeah.
And or bathed, right?
Yes.
I think she's terrific after a bath, so I'll say scrubbed.
That's it! You all got it. They all got that right. Absolutely, we'll split the pot three ways. We'll come back in a moment and split the big one. The $300 one's coming up. Don't go away.
Daytime is playtime with our most popular shows.
Every day you must watch.
Continuing next, only on Buzzer.
We'll decide it for today. $300 riding on this one for the rooting sections. Gang, this is it. Men, do you feel that most people like you the moment they meet you? Here it is. Men, do you feel that most people like you the moment they meet you? Think that one over and we'll come back and find out how you feel about that. Patty, we'll start with you. Most people, yes. Do you feel that most people like Donald the minute they meet him? I asked him the question. Does he think that?
I think he thinks that.
Are you going to qualify that answer? No.
No, you said go fast.
Well, I think most people like Donald the first moment they meet him. You'll say yes, he thinks so too. Let's bring him on. Fast Donald, do you feel that most people like you the moment they meet you?
When they meet me, I take off my hat, say hello, they love me.
That's it. Thank you, Donald. Pam,
anytime.
How about Rick? Does Rick
This is
feel...
easy. Blue section, we've got it made. No.
He doesn't feel that?
No, people don't like him.
Really?
Really.
Gee, then when I met him backstage...
He's very shy, though. You see, he's very shy, and he just is very...
Yeah.
So people get the wrong idea.
Oh, that's because... I met him backstage at the Sahara in Las Vegas, and I immediately just took to him. I thought he was terrific. But you think
people
he'll say no.
People are scared of him, too, because his...
Well, yes, he is imposing. That's true. All right, you'll say he'll say no.
Oh, yeah, this is easy.
Let's bring him on. Rick, do you feel that most people like you the moment they meet you?
I'm a very good, very difficult person to get to know, so I would have to say no.
That's right. That's what she said. You have a share of the pot. Barbara, what's Rick going to say?
My God, my husband and her husband, there must be a standoff out there because my husband's the same way. He's very hard to get to know.
Really?
No, most people do not like him at first.
Okay, at first meeting, let's bring him on, see what he says. Here he comes now. Rick, do you feel that most people like you the moment they meet you?
No, I
don't. That's it. You got it. We spin it three ways, gang. Guess what? The Red Sox with Barbara and Rick have won it for today. We'll be back in a moment. Let you know how much Barbara and Rick have won. The Red Sox is going bananas. See you in a moment. Winners, the Red Sox with Rick and Barbara, $375. We had $1,375. Congratulations, you are all splendid. We'll see you next time on Tattletales. Goodbye, everybody.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program has been edited for broadcast.